children, let's start with the
question number 17. 17 has three parts. The same 7, three different methods we have to solve. So A, y is equal to, first you have to, what do we take? U into V form we have to take and find the derivative. Is it? So this will keep, first we'll keep as a constant and we'll take the derivative of x cube plus 7x plus 9. Then what we'll get? Is it? If we take the derivative of this, we'll get 3x plus 7. Okay. Then second remain constant, and we'll take the derivative of the first one, which will be 2x minus 5. 2x minus 5. This is the first. With respect to u into v form. Okay. Second, we have to multiply it and then take the derivative. So if you multiply here, it will be x5 and x into that 7x cube. Then x into that 9, it is 7x square. We will have to multiply, then take the derivative. So y, after simplification, you get this one, that it is 5x cube minus 5x is to 4 plus 15x cube minus 26x square minus 11x plus 72. Is it? Now we have to take the derivative with respect to y. So dy by dx is equal to, with respect to y, it will be 5x is to 4 minus 5, 4 is 20, 20x cube. Then 45 plus x square minus 26 2s are 52x minus 11. Is it? This will be the answer. Okay, this is multiplying. Now third, with the logarithm. Is it? Third method is with the logarithm. So y, so log y is equal to log x square minus 5x plus 8 plus log x cube plus 7x plus 9. Now take derivative with respect to x. So 1 by y is equal to divide by dx. This is log this x square minus 5x plus 8. Okay, we take the derivative of this one inside. So what will be the derivative of inside 2x minus 5 plus? With respect to log, it will go in the denominator. And if we take the derivative of x cube plus 7x plus 9, we will get 3x square plus 7. Okay, just you have to simplify it. This will be the answer. And the y will move on that side. So it will be dy by dx. Okay. Fine. Then y here, then what will get? This one. You can substitute the denominator. And answer will be this two. Okay. Fine. So 18. Let's move on to sum number 18. Y is equal to u v.
This here,
first u and v. Is it taken as a second? So this will be first, this will be first. So we'll take these two, first and second. The first will remain constant and we'll take the derivative of this. Second, then second remain constant, we'll take the derivative of dy by dx of u. If we take, then this is okay. Now this is a constant u into v. This we have to take derivative. So again, u will remain constant and we'll take derivative of dv by dx plus wv as a constant and we'll take the derivative of u, that is wv dv by dx. Okay? Isn't it? This will be simple derivation. And if logarithm differentiation is there, this is product rule. According to the product rule, we find. Now, according to the logarithm derivative, this is log y, log u into v plus w, that is log y is equal to log u plus log v plus log w. Is it? Now, with respect to y, 1 by y divided by dx, 1 by u du by dx, 1 by v dv by dx, 1 by u dw by dx. Is it? Okay. So, if you take divided by dx, y will multiply from there, and if you just write it down, u, v, w. If you take LCM, u, v, w, so this will be cancelled out. So here will be, or you can multiply inside, so u and u will cancel, v by w, v u by w, and here v. So u and w will be here, and v by x, and if you multiply inside, so w will cancel out, u by v, v by dx.
Let us do two extra sum. 3 we are done with that method, log e raised to log e. Is it? So that are the two examples. So let's see how we'll prove it. Here x raised to y, plus y raised to x is equal to a raised to b. So if you apply log, e raised to log e, is it e raised to log e x raised to y plus e raised to log e y raised to x is equal to e raised to log e a raised to b. So this will come here, not in multiplication, on the top of e. So it will get e is equal to e raised to y log e raised to x. Here e raised to x log e raised to y. Okay, e raised to b log e raised to a. Okay, is it? Now, first respect to a raised to x. A raised to x means same. Then we have to take the derivative of what? Y log a raised to x. Is it? This is u into v form. So y constant and log x or e raised to x is 1 upon x plus log e raised to x common. We'll take the derivative of y as dy by dx. Same on this side. First we have to take the derivative of e raised to x. E raised to x will remain as it is. Then we'll take the derivative of x log e raised to y. X is a constant. We'll take the derivative of log y as 1 upon y dy by dx. Is it? Plus log e as a log e raised to y constant, and derivative of x is 1. Okay. Fine. So what will get? Log e raised to log e raised to x raised to y. Here in the bracket is y upon x plus log e raised to x dy by dx. Here e raised to, okay, again we'll multiply x up. So log e raised to log e x y raised to x. Simplify this, x upon y dy by dx plus log e raised to y. What is log e raised to log e? E raised to log e is 1, so we'll get again back y raised to x. Here also log e raised to log e will get 1, and we'll get back x raised to y. So x raised to y, and this is a matter of simplification. Okay, yes, we got it. Is it? This is a just simplification. You got it. Now multiply inside. X raised to y, is it? Log e raised to x, and then dy by dx will, if you multiply this here, and dy by dx constant. So directly also you can do e x raised to y dy by dx, is it? So what is it you multiplying here? X raised to y log e raised to x dy by dx as a common, and here y raised to x, okay, into x upon y dy by dx. You can take common, so it will be coming dy by dx in the bracket, and another bracket you can write plus x raised to y by x plus y raised to x here plus log e raised to y. Is it? Directly also you can take in common. This we have to take common, and this including after multiplication we have to match it, and then we have to take common. Is it clear? And the rest again multiply inside and then take common directly. So you are reducing it. Now what will get? X. Okay, can we take anything common from here? We have to see here x. Now y, it is x, so y x minus 1. If you take this common here x, if it is y minus 1, so x is here, okay, x, and x raised to y. So if you take what x common, I think we'll take x common. Now x raised to y, is it? Okay, here it is x raised to y log e raised to y, and this one. If you simplify this one, what is the b? Y. Here it's also y. Is it? So y will go up and will be written as y raised to x minus 1 into x. So this we have to take. Is it? Again, y raised to x, this base is 1. So y is taken up. So what will get? X into y raised to x minus 1 plus x raised to y log e raised to x. And this will bring it on the other side, it will be minus, same thing in the bracket. Here also see, your base is x, here also base is x. But x is to y, but this is x here. So this will, x will move up, then what will get? X, y minus 1 into y, plus this as it is. Okay, then you just divide it. Okay, so what you get? Minus x
x raised to y minus 1 into y plus x raised to y into log e raised to x, and this will go in denominator.
Fifth extra sum, if y raised to x is equal to e raised to y minus x, then prove that. This is to prove that. Okay, so let's apply y, same thing, log, if you apply log e, say y raised to x is equal to log e raised to e y minus x, is it? Log e we apply. The same method what we'll do. It is not written here, but it is not necessarily to be written. We say log e. Okay, log e. Is it? Now just multiply, so we will get x log x, and here e raised to e is log e raised to e is 1, so you'll get x minus y. Now we'll take a derivative with respect to x. X is a constant. Okay, derivative of y is 1 by y dy by dx plus log y is constant and derivative of x is 1. So here y dy by dx minus x. Is it? Now we have to collect dy by dx on one side. So y by x minus this will come on this side. So it will be minus 1. Dy by dx is taken common. This you bring on this side. It will be minus and then take common. So you'll get y upon x minus 1 dy by dx. And this will move on that side. It will be minus taken common. So it will be also minus. So 1 plus log e raised to 1. Okay. So dy by dx is equal to minus 1 plus log e raised to y upon here x upon y minus 1. Okay. If you take LCM of y will move up and x minus y. So dy by dx is equal to y log 1 plus log e raised to y. Okay. Understand? This is y minus x. If you change the sign x minus y, this y sign minus you have to remove. We have taken y up, and if you change this sign in place of x minus y, if you write y minus x, this sign will vanish. So that what exactly we did here. So dy by dx is equal to y from up LCM, it is gone up, and we change it in place of x minus y, we wrote y minus x, so this minus sign is vanished. So dy by dx is equal to y, 1 plus log e raised to y upon y minus x. So dy by dx is equal to log y in the bracket, 1 plus log e raised to y upon, is it, x. Okay, what is here value x minus y? You have to substitute the value of what is x minus y. Is it? How to get it x minus y? Here, x minus y. X minus y is what? X log y. Is it? X log y. So instead of this y minus x, we substitute from here x log y. So we substitute x log y. Okay? So we get dy by dx is equal to y upon x. Inside the bracket, we'll say that 1 plus log e raised to y upon log y. Okay? Understand? So this, what do we get again? If we substitute, what is value of x upon y? Is it? What is x upon y? If we substitute what they say, x upon y, if you get from there, is it? Here, that is there, x upon y. X upon y is log e raised to y. And it was already there, log 1 plus e raised to y. If you substitute x upon y as log e raised to y, we'll get it from there first equation only. Is it? Then if we simplify this, we'll get log 1 plus log e raised to y plus 1 plus log e raised to y. If you multiply then square, and that is what we were supposed to prove. You can see here I did log y is equal to x. This from here only I brought it. Is it? Bring it on that side, so it is x will upon it will be divided, so y upon x minus 1, x upon x is 1. Is it? So log y is equal to y upon x minus 1. So if you want to know what is the value of x upon y, minus 1 will go that side, so y upon x is log y plus 1. Is it? That what I substitute here, what is x upon y.